Hello, I'm Anthony Vaughn with the Texas Instruments Precision Analog Marketing Team. Today, I will demonstrate how to set up TI's ADS8910B Performance Demonstration Kit. The ADS8910B is an 18-bit, single-channel, 1 megasample per second precision ADC with an integrated reference buffer. This device features a differential input and the innovative multiSPI digital interface that solves many throughput challenges while remaining backward compatible with traditional SPI communication. This performance demonstration kit for the ADS8910B is ideal for acquiring data and evaluating several performance aspects of the ADC. This kit includes a quick start guide, a micro USB cable, two small circuit boards, and mounting screws. One board is the Precision Host Interface, or PHY, and the other board is the ADS8910B Evaluation Board, or EVM. The PHY serves as an interface between the PC and the EVM. The PHY board features a TI Satara AM3352 embedded processor, an FPGA, a micro USB connector, and an SMA connector. There is also a connector on the bottom of the board that attaches to the EVM. The EVM board features the ADS8910B ADC, two differential input SMA connectors, two OPA625 low distortion ADC drivers, a 5-volt REF 5050 based reference, a TPS 7A4700 low noise LDO, and a connector for the PHY board. To get started using the kit, first download and install the software available at the link below. The software must be installed on a PC running Windows 7 or 8 64-bit operating systems. After the software has been installed, connect the PHY to the EVM board like this. To avoid connection problems, the screws included with the kit should be used to make a secure connection between the two boards. Next, plug one end of the micro USB cable into the PC and the other end into the PHY board. The green power LED will illuminate on the PHY board, indicating that the board is being properly powered. Two additional LEDs will begin blinking after proper communication has been established between the PC and the PHY. If these LEDs do not start blinking, check the USB cable connection and make sure that the ADS8910B software has been properly installed. A differential signal source can then be applied to the EVM board via the two SMA input connectors. After all the hardware connections have been made, launch the ADS8910B software. The application can be launched by going to the Windows Start menu and selecting the ADS8910B EVM application. Once the software has finished loading, it will open the Time Domain Display screen. Several ADC settings can be made with the controls on the left side of the screen. Several multiSPI digital interface parameters, including the S-clock frequency and the number of SDO data pins for use in the data transfer, may be configured. You may also select the sampling rate for the ADC on this screen. The time domain display will also allow you to select the number of samples to take. Pressing the capture button will start the data acquisition. After data has been captured, it will be shown as a waveform on the screen. You can zoom into a portion of the waveform to look at specific samples more closely. This window will also allow you to right-click on the waveform in order to copy the data and paste it into another application for further analysis or processing. This screen also displays the maximum and minimum codes in the acquisition in addition to the corresponding max and min signal voltages. Next, I would also like to show you the spectral analysis window. This screen will allow you to capture data and view it in the frequency domain. You can zoom into the fundamental frequency and then view the signal and the associated harmonics by clicking on the Mark Harmonics checkbox. Other performance parameters like signal-to-noise ratio, total harmonic distortion, signal power, and effective number of bits can be viewed in this screen. The software will also allow you to analyze several other performance parameters of the ADC, like differential nonlinearity and the integral nonlinearity, in the linearity analysis window. The GUI calculates linearity using sine wave inputs. There's also a reference settling analysis window available to analyze the droop of the ADC's voltage reference when the data is captured in bursts. For more information about TI's ADS8910B Precision SAR ADC, or to order the development kit, visit the link below. I hope that you have found this overview useful. Thank you for watching.